You know what the best part of that was? I had the stream audio in the background, and I didn't realize that it was doubling over until the very end of that. Great start. Great, great start. All right, well, here we are. Back on the Switch. I wonder if the name Fight means something. So, a robot named Fight is a roguelike Metroidvania focused on exploration and item collection. Okay, if this is a roguelike, this could be either a very long stream or a very short stream. Explore different procedurally generated labyrinth each time you play and discover randomized power-ups to traverse obstacles, find secrets, and explode meat beasts. Oh, right, because we're a robot. Brings permadeath, procedural generation, and countless quick playthroughs to the Metroidvania genre. So I am cautiously optimistic about this one. Not cautiously, cautiously. Don't ask me what the difference is. Super fighting robot? Fight man? Heard this game is good. I mean, when I looked it up, the reviews seemed okay. The GameFly score was lower, but that's because most GameFly users are troglodytes. But yeah, I am cautiously optimistic about this one. Well, the opening music is already giving me that classic vibe. Controls. It'll probably just be better if I get into the game and then. Oh, that's a nice little touch. I like when they have little options like these. Oh, and there's a seated run option too. Nice. Well, that's one way to do a tutorial. Oh, gee. Well, I definitely see the Metroid part of the Metroidvania so far. So far, this is Super Metroid controls. But you know what? Super Metroid is like one of my all-time favorites, so I am okay with that. Hold on. Just gotta make sure I'm not missing anything. Part of me was hoping that an E-tank would pop up in one of those walls.
Okay. There we go.
Careful.
I misread that as can be donated to Shriners. My mind is elsewhere right now.
Probably stopped after dying once and realizing how the roguelike mechanics work.
I mean, I don't think any of them actually know what a roguelike is. Can we confirm that? Oh, there we go. I wonder if you can wall jump in this game. Doesn't seem like it. Oh, okay, that's a little odd. Note to self, do not stand next to those. Like the controls for Super Metroid. Well, by modern standards, the controls for Super Metroid are very unusual. But personally, I never had an issue with them. Oh, I'm doing this a little too fast. I almost made a terrible joke that wouldn't have worked because of the name of this game. I almost said, so is our robot named Sam? But no, the robot's named Fight, damn it. So when it said roguelike, I was kind of expecting to be dead by now, but so far that hasn't happened. Yeah, I'm just gonna camp out for this one. I mean, you can change that command. I know I did. Well, I mean, to be fair, I changed it more recently because the select button on my SNES controller stopped working consistently. Yeah. Oh, pff. I look away and now I'm getting hit. So do you think wall jumping is actually going to become a mechanic at some point? I kind of hope not, because if there's one thing I didn't like about Super Metroid, it was how wall jumping worked in that game. Don't drop any death traps on the way to go. I mean, that is a fair point, but I'm also a person who died in seconds playing Binding of Isaac, so all bets are off when it comes to me and roguelikes. I see what you're doing there. So the movement is a little stiff, but at the same time, the guy's a robot, so I'm not expecting him to be particularly nimble. That didn't take long. Then again, I wasn't expecting a boss fight that quickly. Oh, jeez, that took off a ton of health. I don't know why I'm shooting the same things that I know, don't unveil paths. I'm wary of this because the last time I blasted it open, I immediately got hit. There it is. Oh, this is not as good of a start as before. Wall jumps were a hidden technique. Yeah, but if you knew how to do them, you could still do them right away in Super Metroid. Here, I'm trying to do it, and it doesn't seem like there's anything there. So if it is in this game, you'll just have to straight up unlock it. Well, and the map's different. Thank you. Health, anyone? There we go. Slide instead of more pulpers? Jeez. More like a robot named Dread, am I right? No, I'm not. I mean, aside from being a little sluggish, it controls pretty well so far. What is down there? All right, this is more offense oriented sort of thing. You know what? I'm okay for that with this seed. With that for the seed. I can English sometimes. I have a degree in it, I'd hope so. Oh! So there's also unlocks related to just hitting certain milestones, I guess. Oh, there is something to unlock a wall jump. And it's permanent across all run. Okay. Good to know. Very good to know. That looks like something that needs a certain item. Yep. Oh, I think my sticks are starting to drift a bit. Oh, is this going to be for the door that we passed earlier? Hold on, let's see how this works. Yeah, basically a charge beam. Feels like there's a little more of a delay on my shot because it has to like build up the electricity. Deal with that guy. Those are achievements, which includes the wall jump. All right. Well, at least they found a decent way to translate that into this release. Oh, and what might you be? Okay, I wasn't expecting Greek mythology references in this game, but sure. Oh well, fuck you too. You know, this might end up being kind of a boring GameFly stream, because I'm actually enjoying myself. Don't worry, there's plenty of other shit still on the GameFly queue. Which, actually, the reason I haven't done a GameFly in a while is because my queue ran out, and I just didn't realize it. There's something up here. I'm not sure what that symbol means. Oh well. Well, yeah, exactly, Blondie. How dare I enjoy myself? Oh, this sounds like a boss is coming up. Those are shrines, giving a certain amount of scrap for special reward. I mean, based on what it said, I kind of figured that was what was going on, but, like, it's still so early in the game that I just wouldn't have anything. Okay. Well, I'll admit, we beat a boss faster than I thought we would. Although that boss was, like, really simple with its pattern. So are we in Brinstar now, or... What's the second area in Axiom Verge called? Because with, like, the enemy design, I'm kind of getting the Axiom Verge vibe. Oh,
Okay.
Background numbers of the room itself or the tutorial guide. Oh, I didn't even see numbers in the background. I'm worried that it's going to get really dark at some point, because I can see like a faint light outline, like in a circle around my guy. My guy fight here. Thanks, one roll for the raid. This is... I mean, I can tell you all the things this game is not. It is not Metroid. It is not Castlevania. It is not Axiom Verge. What it is a game with a robot named Fight. Ah, hell no. Come on. There we go. I was afraid that's what that was. Alright, we need the... Wait, what's the legally distinct version of the Varia suit? Oh, that room was a revenant state. Respawn if you die one. Okay, good to know. I assume that you just kind of figure out a lot of these things as you go. The mirror doesn't look odd when you rotate while having the charge on. Okay, not an enemy. Okay. I see what they did here. Nice. I don't think I can actually make anything with this. No, I can't, but good to know that exists. Oh shit, this was a bad idea. Okay, yeah, we're just not gonna do that for a bit. This is a roguelike, right? Yeah. So I died earlier and the map is different, the pickups are different. But I mean, it basically plays like Super Metroid, so I'm just vibing. That is a cheap move, but I was ready for you. Wait, is this something that teleports you, or is it something that... No, it wouldn't reveal part of the map, because there's still hidden parts. Yeah, that's the first one of those I've seen. So if it's a teleport thing, then it won't go anywhere. Okay, where have I not... Oh, up and to the right. Metroid mod or something else? No, this is a robot named Fight. This is its own little game. If you like Metroid... If you like to have Metroid, like the later Castlevanias, Axiom Verge, and then like roguelike elements on top of that, then maybe this is your thing. Oh. Okay, I should get light for doing that. Okay, there is a little bit of light here. Don't tell me all the rooms are gonna be like this. Oh, I don't like the sound of that. Well, we're unlocking plenty of stuff just by wandering around. We got it! I like how they called it sequence break, because that's pretty much what that mechanic is for. Yeah, this is basically gonna work the same way. Ah, jeez. The hell was that? You know, maybe we shouldn't be in the factory yet. Just maybe. Whoa, I found a thing. Oh, those are, okay, they're in the ceiling. I'm just gonna leave. Oh crap, where am I? Ah, there we are. Oh god. Well, I'm probably gonna die. Yeah, I couldn't see shit. Oh well. Okay, well, that respawn came in handy. Now, is there a menu where I can see all the things I've unlocked? I'm trying to do the wall jump and it's not quite working out. Assuming I'm doing it right. Where else can I go? Alright, there are plenty of doors that I just missed before. But I need to be able to do this. There we go. So there's way more of a delay on that than just doing the Super Metroid version. Here there's a very deliberate pause that you need to make before, like, changing direction and then hitting jump, so that threw me off a bit. At least those spikes didn't do too much damage. right, I can't get through there. Shit. Okay, well, that severely limits my options. I have a feeling that every time I die and respawn, I'm going to get new items, but they won't be the items that I'll need to progress. Because that's already happened with the slide. Try moving all the way down again. God, I keep hitting the wrong button when I want to bring up the map. Oh, hell no. I'll go the long way around. I don't want to deal with that many spikes. Whoa, that was weird. He kind of sunk through the ground for a moment. I'm always going to be looking for hidden stuff in the walls for little rooms like that. Oh, these things are more nimble than I gave them credit for. I'm on to you, game. jeez. How many barfing enemies are going to be in this game? That's what, the third one I've seen so far? Well, I mean, so far, this is looking to be a very easy call for the... There's a speed boost. Of course there's a speed boost. I can wall jump off the sides of platforms. Oh, geez, I can only imagine what the speedruns for this look like. Probably a lot like the Super Metroid speedruns. Speaking of, isn't GDQ going on right now? I'll try to check that out at some point. Oh no, it's this game's version of the Red Skeleton. We got the very heat shell. All right, we can make progress. Need to be careful. Don't want to get Nintendo on my ass. Also, I haven't mentioned it, but that little, like, magnetism thing that happens when an item is close to you, much appreciated. Like that. Wait, am I going the right way? Oh, the hot rooms are above me. Yeah. Common sense told me, go down, the hot room is below you. Common sense failed me. Oh my god, you're right. Our heat-resistant shoulder pads do look like basketballs. Not only do they offer us protection, but we can also hear round ball rock everywhere that we go. Oh wait, I can get through here. Yeah, we're not taking damage. All right. We're doing it. We're doing the thing. This is just going to make my eventual death all the more painful. Excuse me. Huh. I don't know what that does, but it's unlocked, so I will enjoy that. Actually, I'll go up here first. Or not. Okay, I was gonna say, that better not still damage me. Again, I don't know what that did, but I'm assuming something good. Yeah. Aesthetic stuff? I mean, probably, considering it was unlocked by just having 50 scrap in my inventory. Well, that didn't take long. Oh wow, this is a completely different starting space. Wait, let's check. Yep, still got the wall jump. That's a fair point, comrade. It was kind of odd that, like, of all the things that that guy could have said, he just spewed lore about the mechanical god. Do it? Yes, we can. High jump boots? Oh, double jump. Close enough. I mean, in certain Metroid games, the high jump is a double jump. It's a beholder. Chaotic, but not bad for a first boss. Oh, mouth meat, that's what that was. Funny to think it wasn't until Dread that 2D Metroid got a double jump. Oh, okay. I was going to say that, but I haven't played all of the 2D Metroid, so I didn't know if that was the case. Gonna be one of those rooms where you have to like hold on. Might be able to cheese this. Got it. Oh, I didn't know if I was going to be able to pull that off, or if that was even possible. We're getting all the speed tech in. God, that reminds me, I do want to, like, go back and try running Super Metroid at one point. I started by trying to learn, like, the hardest route for the category I wanted to do, which was not a smart idea at all. And I can't get through here. So, that was pointless. Tank, excellent. Metroid Shenanigans with the Pixel Edge Jump. That's exactly what I was doing. Because in the expert route for Super Metroid, there's like a couple of instances where you have to do a wall jump. Like, as you're passing over like the top of one of these ledges, let's say I'm jumping from this side going this way, you would jump in such a way that you just passed the edge of that, and then wall jump off of the ledge you just floated over. Also, I'm realizing you can trigger the double jump after just walking off a ledge. That's incredibly handy. We're the Silver Surfer now. He's probably not a bad player to watch for that stuff. Like, him and Behemoth. I remember just watching them go back and forth. Holy shit, I was not expecting that. Or, Oats. Oats is another good one. Wait, I want that heart. Once you get the pattern down for that, that's not a bad boss fight. Hover boots! Cephalodetera. There were so many O's and D's in there that I struggle with the pronunciation. There's only one O and one D in there. I don't know why I struggle with that so much. Whatever, give me all the boots. Right, I keep forgetting I have those. Oh, I thought it meant bolts as in missiles. My bad. Well, hopefully with that I can get through that one door that I passed. Won't have trouble illuminating dark corridors anymore. I wonder if this does like decent like damage over time to bosses. Oh wait, I've already been here. Shit. Come on. Oh shit. Thanks, Revenant of Pi, for the $10. I hear that alert so little that I didn't know what happened at first. I'm always gonna be suspicious of those long hallways. By the way, Bai, how are you doing? Let me think about this for a moment. Metroid, but gore is what you're saying is... Yeah, I said this a couple times now, but it's... Metroid, the Egovania-style Castlevanias, Axiom Verge, and then a bunch of roguelike shit thrown on top of it. Oh, yep, that is in fact what that's for. Ah, shit, I was too slow. How do you get out of here? Come on, there's gotta be a way out. What is it? Missile, maybe? Maybe. If I can remember how to use them. Swap weapons. But it doesn't seem like I have another weapon. Wait a minute. Okay, that's weird. Wait a minute, I'll do the other one first. Oh, this seems familiar. We've definitely seen elements of this in a previous map. I'm gonna check that other door first. Hey, it's you again. You're gonna tease me like this game? Okay. Yeah, that's what I thought. Okay, so what does this do? Oh! You know what? I like it. Detour was worth it. I don't have anywhere I can go yet. Assuming that is a teleporter, I'm just kind of guessing. I can't remember if I went there or not. Just in case. Oh yeah, I did not go here yet. Looks like it's going to go somewhere a little deeper, so... I like it. So I'm not used to mechanics like that, but I mean, it's something I can get used to. Now that I've played this a few times, I'm definitely seeing where, like, elements from certain past runs that I've done are starting to overlap. Do the top side first. Well, I don't like the sound of that. Looks like the lead up to the baby Metroid. Or is it just the factory? Oh, jeez, that goes through walls. We're getting all the machine gods in this one. Oh, you are my favorite machine god. I'll hail Wadget. Whatever. Going to die soon. Come on, we can Mega Man this. Oh, shit. Well, I mean, we did, but it didn't have the desired outcome. Oh, great. Okay, if there's one thing I dislike about this game so far, it's that. Just, like, dropping on top of an enemy that you don't know is there. That's kind of a mess. Jeez. These look like homunculi that were rejected from a clay fighter game. We'll be right back. every enemy I encounter has so much potential to just kill me outright. Oh shit. It is a teleporter. Let's see what it looks like. Alright, cool. I mean, it's a teleport animation. Damage does this thing take? There we go. Okay, that's an odd way to do fleas, but, cool? Little annoying, but cool? Aw, come on. Okay, at least I got the respawn. That set me back a ways, though. Even if I use the teleporter, it's still gonna be a while. Unless I just take a different path before then. Taking a wrong turn? I am taking a wrong turn. What am I doing? Come on, puke, damn it. There you go. Ah, damn it, I thought I was close enough to the edge. Man, can I even get through that door? I'm gonna try something. I don't have the electric beam, but maybe I can use that one ability. Nope, that's not gonna work. Oh well, on to the next. There it is. Straight across here, and oh right, this area. You'd think I would remember this area. I've seen it like half a dozen times by now. Apologies if I'm not talking too much, I'm just kind of getting lost in the game. Not lost as in I don't know where I'm going, just lost as in I'm completely focused on it. Nope, not dreaded at all. Actually, when did this game come out? Because I don't want to say like, oh, it's copying this from Dread, if it came out before Dread.
Jeez.
Man, I've already been playing this for an hour and a half? Damn. The whole having fun for a change thing is throwing off my perception of time for GameFly streams.
Right.
You know what? It worked for that monster, so it's good in my book. ...2017, a week before Samus returns. Okay, that helps put it into perspective. And so this even predates Samus Returns. That's impressive. That was a little nerve-wracking. Okay, time for some precision platforming. We got this. Arachnomorph. Oh, is this Spider Ball? Please tell me it's Spider Ball. I mean, technically you're turning into a spider-like thing, and you're roughly the size of a ball, so I'm counting it. Oh, and you can still shoot in this mode, and double jump. Hold on, can you wall jump in this? Doesn't seem like it. Okay. Slight limitation. So they're trying to innovate a bit. They're not just straight up copying things from Metroid entirely. I just realized it's kind of weird that you have this like sci-fi setup for everything, but the icon for your attack is still a sword. Like for your attack strength on the left. Or maybe the sword just means that we have one moderator in Robot Named Fight's chat. Yes, Blondie, the game is referring to you. My right hand is getting a little stiff. I kind of had it sitting weird on my hand. On my leg, I mean. Let's go. Oh god, I'm really bad at hitting these things in motion. Key for me is just hit them like at the very top or very bottom of their pattern. Oh, I think we got a boss in here. I have a bad feeling about this. Ah, damn it. So, I'll restart, but I'm not going to, like, go that deep into the seed, because I do have other shit to do. Okay, this seed looks a lot similar to the one that I first had. Oh! Immediate E-tank, alright. Yes, the Not Cyrus from Fusion. I'll admit, I still haven't played Fusion yet. So, when I first saw that boss, my mind went to, what's the name of the thing from A Link to the Past? that it can like knock you off the stage and then you have to do the fight over. It's not like I heard bad things about Fusion. I probably would like Fusion if I played it. I just haven't gotten to it yet. Hey! You haven't played much GB yet? Like, I'm sure I would like it if I played it. It's just that I can count on one hand the amount of GBA games I have ever played. And most of them weren't good. That's the sad thing. Oh, if only. Wait a minute. I'm on to you. There we go. I'm a little slow, but I get there eventually. The stream. I have something that I could use because I did a little prep work in advance for the Seiken Densetsu retrospective. That's all I'm gonna say. Hey, it's you again. The wall jump didn't work. Probably because of the door. get this to... Come on. There we go. Is this gonna be that same room before where I cheesed it with the pixel wall jump? Yeah, I'm not gonna be able to do that because I don't have the double jump. I'm getting to know this particular style of map a little too well. I'll say it's cool that they're able to, like, randomly generate parts of the map and still make it be able to work within the Metroidvania formula. Like, I'm getting a phase shot early, and they're making sure they have things early on that relate to the phase shot. I have played, like, worse Metroidvania-style games that just did a really bad job accounting for that. Oh, you didn't miss anything, One Roll. I was just saying that I have my ways of being able to play Metroid Fusion when I get to it. These assholes can cloak now? Damn it. Okay, where am I supposed to go? Oh, of course. Damn. I'm gonna go a very particular way. Alright, I would say I'll play your game, you rogue, but I am playing their game, and it's a roguelike. Thank you. try the one without that on it first. Hey. For a moment I thought that said speed booster and I got excited. Gee, what does that look like? Subtlety comes and goes with this game. Have a good night, One Roll. Hey, our old buddy. Kind of put myself in that situation, huh? Let's go. Oh, we got a boss coming up. Do I fight it in just this mode? I'll try fighting it just with this and see what happens. Probably death. Oh, this asshole. Okay, now that I know what the tell is for when it's going to do that, this boss fight isn't nearly as bad. Hey, the tribe triple shot. Fight wants a what? I'm not gonna bother with the save because I'm gonna shut this game off soon. It's getting late. I have shit to do for tomorrow. One thing I would like on this map is a little color coding for like some of the locked doors that you need a weapon to open. Yep, that did it. Oh, great, more cloaking enemies. Oh, I was thinking I'll be dead soon, but no, the health tank says otherwise. I mean, I could just stop playing, but that would involve me, like, stopping playing a game that I'm actually having fun with. So I want to savor this. Oh, if only. Well, shit. Yeah, this room looks exactly the same as one of the ones from before. Oh, it's a fake out. Who knows if there will ever be another good one? I mean, You would think there would be another good one at some point. Is there a way to get up there? Damn, I was hopeful. Pretty sure your Sega CD roulettes had a better good to bad game ratio than the GameFly streams. But I want, like, a statistical breakdown on that. I think it's close, but I don't know if it goes in favor of the Sega CD. Oh, wow. Well, if we stuck around to kill 1,000 enemies, then, I mean, I must be having fun. I mean, it's usually either that, or I am just in a zombie-like state and not even thinking about what I'm doing. This is definitely not that. I have no idea what that is. I'm guessing it's the Triforce of Wisdom? I don't think a flamethrower will get through that. Nope. Alright, I think I'm going to call it here, because I'm like in the exact opposite corner of where I should be. Collected 18% of the things. That's an okay rate. Still so much crap to pick up. Oh, I was hoping there would be a credits thing that I could roll, but apparently not. Alright, well, I mean, I had fun with that. This is like the easiest call in GameFly history, I think. This is absolutely getting the I don't hate this badge. Excuse me, it's getting the coveted, illustrious SDXCR I don't hate this badge. Yeah, I had fun with that. I might actually see about getting this. Not the GameFly version. I'd want a either a PC version or like a complete boxed version of the game. But aside from that, the usual Monster Hunter stream tomorrow. Not sure what exactly I'm doing, but I'll be doing something. I may actually consider doing a PC Rise, because I have another character on there that I'm trying to advance with. Let me see if anyone I know... That doesn't look like it. Although Games Done Quick is doing Vampire the Masquerade, I might check that out just on my own. Alright, well, thanks for hanging out, and who knows when the next good GameFly game will be. Probably not the next one. I don't know, I don't remember what's in my queue. Later, guys.